Hollywood, California. La película se llama La momia, la tumba del emperador Dragón. Vamos a verlo.
Esto es Hollywood, California, nuevamente sin escape aquí en el lugar de los hechos. Estos son los estudios Universal y se está filmando la nueva película de La momia, la tumba del emperador Dragón. Estos son los soldados de terracota, son réplicas exactas de las figuras chinas. ¿Y qué hacemos acá? Bueno, pues vamos a conversar con Brendan Fraser, que es el protagonista de la película, y nos va a contar más de esta nueva aventura de La momia. Así que como siempre, en exclusiva sin escape desde Hollywood, con ustedes, Brendan Fraser. Vamos a verlo.
Brendan, nice to see you.
Good to see you.
First time on our show, so I'm happy to meet you.
Pleasure's mine.
How did the special effects change since the first movie?
Well, an actor who's had the privilege of coming of age and learning a craft in the last 10 or 12 years, mm-hmm. when I've watched the way that cinematography and visual effects have allowed for anything to be created. Mm-hmm. And what that means is, whereas things were maybe more challenging 8-10 years ago, mm-hmm. now, they're infinitely more simple to shoot and create. And what it means is your actor just has to buy into and believe in the situation mm-hmm. that they're in, combine that with the electronic element, and then give it to its audience. But, you know, beyond all of the, the cinematography, mm-hmm. what's most important is, after all of that, is you just have to have a story mm-hmm. that people can identify with. And in the case of Mummy, Tomb of the Dragon Emperor, mm-hmm. that he had a story that showed that the O'Connells have aged up 7 years or so, 8 years or so since the last picture. And they are a bit bored with their life in a way, though they're not admitting it to each other. You know, they want to get back into the field, and their son, who is headstrong, has made a very important archaeological find in an archaeologically rich nation, and that's mm-hmm. China.
If it's possible, a new movie, it is true, will be Peru, in my country, or it's just an idea?
You got me, man. Uh-huh. I'm hopeful. I love doing my job. Let's see where this one goes, and I hope we're talking about this in a couple of years from now.
And in Peru.
It could be.
Exactly.
You know, I'm going to remember that.
Uh-huh. Okay, that's, so see you there.
I'll hold you to it, man. Thanks, Bruno. I mean, yes!
Muy bien, vamos a conversar con la protagonista de la nueva película de La momia, María. María, how are you?
I'm fantastic, and I'm happy to know you're from Peru. Mm-hmm. I've always wanted to go. I've been waiting for my son to get a little older, because I always told him I'd take him to Machu Picchu and uh-huh. the Amazon. And to hear at the end of this movie, yes. to say, like, maybe in Peru, I think if we do Mummy 4, I would die for it to be in Peru. Oh,
no, but it's beautiful. So hopefully we got a fourth Mummy movie, so you can shoot it there.
Be fantastic.
So in this opportunity, you went in China. So how fun was or how?
I was in China 10 years ago. Mm-hmm. They were in the midst of transition. It was a bit heavy. They were flooding the Yangtze. And it's kind of sad. And now being back these years later, there's such a hope and a vitality and a great energy there mm-hmm. with China becoming this political and economic world power. Mm-hmm. And what I found working with this half Chinese crew, and then we had Australians, and we had Americans, and we had Canadians, it was really this great community. You find that people from our generations were mm-hmm. so similar because of the internet, because of cell phones, because of television, you mm-hmm. know? We have the same sensibility.
Mm-hmm. You look gorgeous in the movie with the costumes of 1940s. So how you feel, you know, dressed up like a period movie, and also it's an adventure movie at the same time, so how was it?
Those costumes were fantastic. Every time I put them on, I felt more elegant, more sophisticated. Uh-huh. I loved it, except fighting in that pink dress. I wore that for like 2 months. They had like 10 dresses made because I kept ripping them, and they had to sew me in the dress every day. And uh-huh. I had to have bigger ones too, because they put me in wires, which they erase.
Exactly. In the computer.
At the end, on the computer. Uh-huh. So I had these big harnesses on that made me look like a balloon. And so at the end, I was like, please make me thin. Please make it match the rest of the movie.
Uh-huh. But look, you look absolutely amazing. And also in the Himalaya sequence with this red jacket and the silver fox fur. So.
Can I tell you about the Himalaya sequence?
Well, it's in summertime. No,
summertime in Montreal, 105 degrees. We were sweating, in between every take, our hair and makeup had to come and pat us down. I would rip off my jacket after a take, and I was like wearing a bra, I think. I was so hot.
And next time in Peru. So thank you so much for
I
your time.
So.
And see you maybe in Peru.
I'd love that. Bye, Bruno. Thank you.